have been said by the club already that we want to get him to come and improve our scoring for us. That's the objective. And then the objective for him is also make sure he maintains his reputation. He had been here before, he was at another club. And so he was going to prove himself that, yes, I was, and I'm still is, the other guy.
In terms of goals, how many goals?
No, that one, I don't think it's very, very easy to answer that question. Because if I ask you, how much do you want to earn 2 years' time? I don't think you can give me the exact money you want to earn 2 years' time. And so that one is very difficult.
Okay, so we're done with that. I'm sure we are done with our head coach. So we can move to. Are there any questions for ICU? Okay, so we'll move the microphone to ICU. Okay, so we'll take a few questions for ICU.
Okay, thank you very much, sir. Now, people have time without questioning the direction of the club, especially with the signing of big name players, Samuel, for instance, Hans Kuki and Adebayo. And the situation or the current position of the club doesn't quite reflect the investment that has been in the club as well. So my question is, what really is the direction of the club? Are you seeking to still survive in the Ghana Premier League? Are you grooming players to sell off to local or foreign teams? What is really the direction of the club?
Thank you. It looks like I understand your question in twofold, where you try to answer your own self. The first and then the last time I had a press engagement, I said, one, Lagos City is first and foremost a football club. And secondly, we are going to run the football club as a business. So to go straight to answer to your point, we've not, that's the direction of the club. It's a football club, and we're going to run it as business. Now, what makes it a football club? It's quality players. And out of the quality players, you can make business out of it, be it locally and internationally. And one of them is the names you call, is a manifestation of getting Adebayo. Adebayo coming in first serves as an investment, and we move our situation up there, attracts other suitors, be it in Africa or outside, and then we trade, right? So basically, to answer to your question, it's about business. We move the brand, we trade the brand with the players, and we get it going. At the same time, we are in competition for the football.
If you have a question, you can answer that.
Not exactly. With Asamoah, for instance, what would you say has been the return on investment at this point?
Well, if you're putting numbers to it, then I'll tell you, unless you come to my table and I will see. Because Asamoah, like I keep on saying, Asamoah was signed for both purpose. He's one a footballer and then his brand assets. I mean, you can attest to the fact Asamoah coming to add to the Lagos City brand has given it a big mileage. If you are looking at the numbers, then you come there, we look at my balance sheet. Right? So from where we sit, yes, we've not got it 100%, but I'll say for now, we're almost breaking even for bringing him on board. Right? In this worry time of COVID. But the focus is on. We've not moved up from where we wanted to do. It takes quite a while. I know we are trying to do something different than the normal system where people or other clubs take it as a social event. We see it as business. And if you're in business, it's a long haul. So if you're looking at a quick fix answer to tell you, okay, I put in two, I'm getting five today, then probably you think we don't know what we are doing. But it's a long-term investment. It takes quite a while.
Okay, still morning. Good morning to all of you. And as usual, we want to apologize for the big start of the program. We're going to try and keep this as short as we can. So if you have any questions, we will take them. We'll be very glad to take them. But let me just quickly introduce the gentleman you see on the high table. I'm sure everyone here is familiar, but I'll start. Okay, someone said no. So I'll start from my far right. That's Mr. Terry Maxwell-Lyden. He's a CEO. He doesn't like this. He doesn't enjoy this part of the business. So that's why you never see him. That's why you never hear his voice anywhere. He just prefers to sit in his office at work. So that's our CEO, Mr. Terry Maxwell-Lyden. And then by him, there's a very familiar face to all of you. Our head coach, Bashir Hayford, has also joined us this afternoon. So that's Coach Bashir Hayford. Just by me is our assistant coach, Waleed Mohammed, who would also be serving as our interpreter for today. Our new acquisition speaks Hausa in French. The last time I checked, my colleague, the Victor Chukanaku, would not help me with the French. And I couldn't find anyone either. So we had to find an interpreter to help us. All of you know me. So quickly, I want to start. Maybe Victor will say a few words. And then Coach Waheed would help us with the translation. He says he prefers to speak in Hausa. That's a common language. But if you ask him a question in French, he will try to answer for us as well. So Victor will say a few things in Hausa, and then our head coach will do the translation into English for you. Okay. So Victor, over to you.
Assalamu alaikum. Na gode da journalist da sun zo daga interview na da sai banga. Yanzu ina Denmark. Na zo don da wasiki. Akwai wadansu magana da suna nan cikin Ghana. Ai har suna kewan da sun same ni. Ashe ba su same ni ba. Da wasiki ne ya same ni. Na gode musu. Thank you.
Yeah, I started by to say assalamu alaikum to everyone. I said he's so happy to be part of us. He's happy coming back to Ghana and he's going to play for the city. Yeah, there are some rumors around that he's going to play as well. It's not true. It's Lagos City that he wants to play. So yeah, he has welcomed all of you here and we all want to be as a good friend.
Okay, so those are his introductory comments. Even if we can keep the voice down a bit, it's a very small piece, so that I don't think that you can say we'll disrupt the whole place. So if anyone has a question, we'll pass the microphone around, and then you can ask your question, we'll translate, and then you will speak.
The talking is too much.
There's too much talking there.
Yeah, good morning once again. What he was saying, I said, welcome all of you here. And he said, welcome himself back to Ghana. Yeah, initially everybody thought that he's going to play for Asokok, but it wasn't true. It is Lagos City that came in for him, and he's going to serve Lagos City. We welcome you, the journalists, and we wish Almighty to give us a good program.
Okay, so I'm sure this is okay. Yeah. It's okay. Yeah. All right, so at this point, if you have a question for the player, we'll take it. So I'll start with GC, but and then the father.
I have a question for the player and for specifically given the
to who in particular? The CEO being the coach.
Okay, I think CEO and the coach will be best suits for this. I would want to have the details of the deal. know, so that's for the CEO, then also to the coach. All the players is same, the 13 matches is handled for the consensus. While Victorian at the value. Then also to the value. And you think that life is left. It was for the world, it was the Ghana, it was half. Why the consensus? Thank you so much.
Okay, so the first one has to do with what went into the deal.
Yes, no, that what went into the deal. How many years?
The duration of the contract. Okay, that one I can answer for you.
That's fine.
The contract is up to December of this year. If that's okay with you, the contract is up to December of this year. I'll leave Coach Masede for to answer his part of the question. What are they by looking for?
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.